Good morning and welcome to Wholesome Roots. Yesterday was so exciting and so much fun having Shady give birth and getting a sweet little baby doling that's the prettiest thing I've ever seen. I'm just in awe of the beauty of life right now. And I just checked on the other two and Willow's ligaments are gone. So it looks like it looks like Willow's gonna give birth today. I'm so excited. Like, I teared up like with happiness, overwhelmed with joy, just completely and utterly. This is my calling. This is definitely where I have meant to be my entire life, is to be with the goats and be the goat lady. I could not be any happier than having my goats give birth and having beautiful babies be born of a perfect pairing too. And I'll tell you what, Willow was a perfect breeding too, because her daddy Light is a Honabu buck. And for those of you that know Nubian herd names, it's a really great herd. And her udder is huge already, and she hasn't even given birth yet, and she's a first freshener, and to already have such a great big udder, it's just great that we got those genetics into our herd. It's really a huge accomplishment and a big step forward for us. All right, we've got Willow in here with her mom preparing for birth. She's eating a ton of food. She's got a big old bucket of chaff hay, a new basket of alfalfa hay. You notice they haven't even touched the Bermuda hay. Not interested in that. They like their alfalfa so much more. Mama and baby are doing well. Shady is keeping baby to herself. She's not letting Willow go near her. Which is good, because she's supposed to do that, but Willow's just indifferent anyway. I just noticed that she postures her body differently. If Willow approaches towards the baby, she'll go in between them. Don't eat so fast you sneeze in your hay. But baby appears to be doing wonderfully. Walking and eating and just beautiful. Incredibly beautiful baby. We got very lucky to get a doling this pretty. Usually the pretty ones are bucklings. So in love with her already. And we're not going to decide on any names until after all the goats kid. And then we're going to decide. So we'll see. Still eating? Really? I thought I was going to come back and you're going to be like full-blown labor. Oh boy. All right, so we got all the milk filtered and chilled. So we are back down here at the barn watching Willow. Let's see how fast this goes or how slow. The boys are giving the baby lots of love. Shady's like, are you going to be nice to my baby? Of course they are, Shady. Just like they're nice to you. It's funny because she doesn't have an issue with me and the boys touching the baby, but if Willow starts going towards the baby, she gets a little pushy with Willow.
It's trying to hug her little baby.
Yeah? You love that baby?
Yeah. I never thought about the baby like that before.
Yeah, nice girl.
I wish she'll get some more goats from Dave's house.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I think we have enough of our own goats. Don't you? Especially after everybody has babies.
We haven't had enough of goats, just like Daddy has enough of sheep.
Daddy has like 200 sheep at his work, honey. I don't think we can have that many here. We don't have room for that many. Is that sweet baby, Liam?
That Shady's trying to make it a spotful for 40 little baby teacher.
Oh yeah, she's just raked away all the hay for making a bed.
Yeah.
Got to go up to the house and put Liam down for a nap. Get something to eat myself. Grab my water bottle. and I had to take Shady out because she was being mean to Willow, which I totally didn't expect, especially with how much she wanted Willow with her yesterday. But she was being nervous about the baby. So we put her in the other stall with some fresh hay, and now Willow's alone. And she started bellowing at first, but then she settled down. And she's okay now. I'm gonna go in and sit with her and see what she wants from me. If she wants me to stay back or get close or whatever, I just will go off of her cues. Please don't urinate on me. I was just gonna show you guys. She just had her head in my hand. Like she just, I'm sitting in the corner, letting her decide what she wants. And she came over to me and she just laid her head in my hand. I'm sorry, that's right, you don't like me touching your udder. Okay. Yeah. You're starting to have some contractions that you can actually feel, huh? Starting to notice them more. You sweet girl. I wish I could take your pain from you. Give me a sweet baby. You do want your mama though, huh? And by mama, I mean me. She doesn't want her real mama. Real mama's being meanie. I was gonna say something else, but this is a family show. Look at her. She's like, oh, that takes my mind off of it. Yeah, that helps mommy. That takes my mind off of these big contractions. Yeah, sweet girl. My sweet Willow. Willow, you know you are the most special goat in the whole world. You are. Oh my god, she's the most special goat in the whole world, but don't tell anyone. Yeah. It's funny how they hold their ears up more when they're in pain. I noticed that was Shady. This is my first birthing with Nubian, so this is interesting to see the process with them. And the little nuances, like holding ears up. Yeah, sweet girl. Aww. I hope it goes smoothly. She is a first freshener, which means that she's never kidded before. Sometimes it can be a little harder the first time, just like it is with humans. So I'm hoping that it's good and that she doesn't have any complications. So we're just gonna stay here by her side. Yes, baby doll. I love you. Going kind of slow, but she's definitely starting to show more signs of discomfort, like the contractions are getting stronger. She's been over here in my corner nibbling on me like the entire time, and she just decided to go over there and lay down. I can tell her contractions are getting worse. She just jumped up like she was in shock and ran over to me. Jesus, mama, why does it hurt? Why does it feel like this, mommy? Mommy, make it better. And she's starting to drip a little from her back end, too. So she's getting closer and closer, sweet girl. I'm here, baby. You see how much she loves the fact that I'm here? She would be bellowing right now if I was not in here with her. She's a bit of a screamer like her mom. Surprisingly, she has made it all the way through Liam's nap. So we're still waiting and watching. She's definitely taken longer than Shady, but that's to be expected. She is a first freshener. But she's just still doing the same. Definite signs that she's experiencing more pain with the contractions. She's making noises, like little guttural sounds, and arching her head up to the sky and rubbing it on the wall. All signs of increased pain as the impending delivery approaches. And Ryan might actually be home in time for this one. He is on his way home now, so cross your fingers he gets to see it. Because Willow is his precious baby, so she's probably been waiting for daddy, because she's a little daddy's girl. What do little boys do when they're waiting for goats to be born? They stuff their boots full of hay. Of course. What are you doing, Liam? Putting that in your boot? Drinking all my water? Are you pushing? Is this your first push? Looks like it might be. Yeah. All right, girl, we're counting this as first push. Marking our clocks now. 5:40. Hopefully all goes well from here. Good girl. Good girl. Now you just rest until the next contraction. All right, she just had a strong contraction and she coughed and her water broke. So we are in business. We will have a baby soon. She'll likely only have one because she is a first freshener. Yeah, woohoo! Time for baby. Yeah, sweet Willow. We're here for you, honey bun. Oh, she doesn't know what to do. Up, down, up, down. There's no such thing as comfortable during labor and delivery, is there, honey? I wish Daddy was here. He misses it every time, doesn't he? I can just barely make out hoof coming out. It's just starting to peek out each time she pushes. Looks like two hooves now. That's good. Probably a little nose on the other side. I can't see. Yeah, I definitely see a little toe. Two hooves and a nose. That's what we need to see. I know it sounds horrible, guys, but this is labor. I mean, delivery at this point. And she is a very vocal girl anyway. And this is her first time. Oh, good girl. Good girl. Come on. You got this. Doing a great job. There you go. Great job. I'm seeing a lot ahead. Come on. Oh, yeah. Okay. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. You got it, girl. I like to clear away that from the nostrils there. Once they're trying to gasp like that, that's scary to me. It's totally a matter of opinion on that one, but I try not to intervene, but that's one. There you go. Good girl. Past the shoulders, past the rib cage, and the baby should, yep, make a noise. There you go. Beautiful. Good job, Willow. Good job, sweet girl. Good. Baby. Clean it off. Good girl. This is your job now. Yeah, you gotta clean her off. Or him. I think I might have seen. Yeah. Oh, good job. Oh, she's a little scared of it at first, huh? You good. Good job, girl. You did it. A beautiful brown baby. Yeah.
I know you don't know what to do here, but you gotta start licking your baby off. Come on. Lick it up. Good boy. A little boy. Come on. Willow, you gotta lick it.
Well, it's a beautiful, healthy boy. Willow's not that interested in cleaning it, but she is circling around him very gently and attentive-like. So I'm just gonna step back and see what she does. Let her have her way with getting to know that this is hers. She's just kind of like, what is this? Where did it come from? Yeah, they're calling to each other, so that's good. It's a good way for them to bond. Vocal bonding. I would like her to clean him off more and bond from that. But every mother's a little different, and this is her first time. Well, I can't say the buckling's not trying, a nurse. He's been sucking on her hair everywhere he can get to. But every time he starts to get closer to her udder, she moves. I'm gonna stay back and let them do their thing for now. Ryan got home and took the boys. So there's less distractions in here. So I'm hoping that they'll figure it out. Willow's just a little scared right now. She's just acting a little timid about the whole ordeal. I'm sure within just a few minutes he'll be nursing, and if not, I will be holding her still so he can nurse in the first half hour or so. It's important for them to get that first colostrum, but she's showing a lot more attention and affection, so I think he'll be nursing on his own. Look at him sucking on her neck. He is ready to nurse. She's not gonna know what to do when that happens. I got him to nurse for a little bit, and now I'm gonna go get some molasses water for her. I am so tired, but it's a good satisfying tired. But spending 2 days as midwife has been weary. But I've got my warm molasses water for my girl, Willow. She did such a good job. And I just want to apologize that I have not edited or posted my video yet today from yesterday's kidding. So you're gonna have a little delay maybe on some of these videos, especially if Fancy goes into labor now, because then I'm gonna be stuck sitting with her as midwife. But it's well worth it. You guys, I'm sure, will appreciate the wait once you get to see the kids being born. It's so precious. All right, I'm gonna go check on Fancy and see if she's got any ligaments left. Fancy girl, you tricked us good. We thought you were gonna be the first one to go into labor, and here you are. Still fat and pregnant, and the other two are done. I'm gonna come in there and feel your ligaments if you'll let me. But just by looking at the back of her tail, I don't really notice anything that looks sunken in or sloped dramatically, so I'd be willing to bet she still has her ligaments. She's probably gonna go another 3 weeks. That's how long the buck was here, 3 weeks. So, from today. She's gonna do it to me. All right, Fancy, you're gonna let me check. Well, she's still got them. She's still got them. Girl, you're gonna be testing my patience, aren't you, huh? Knowing my luck, you're just gonna do it when I'm not around. What are you guys doing?
In the hose water.
Did you find a hole in the hose?
Yeah.
Wow, that's so much fun. Liam, you love it. You got all wet.
Yeah, I got it. That was so cool, but that's okay. I can still eat it.
Silly boys. Summertime is here in Georgia.
Well, I think they're doing all right.
So I'm trying to see if she's actually letting him nurse without me interfering. But I had to go up to the house to eat dinner and all that, get the kids a bath. So I did hold her for a minute. Okay, it looks like she's not backing away or anything when he nudges down there. So anyway, I held her and made her hold still while he got a good drink in when we went up to the house. And I just came down here and did it again just to be sure. New moms. I think she's doing good. I just, because I couldn't stick around and watch, I was feeling a little nervous about it. So I'm going to have Ryan put away the goats now and see if he can keep an eye and watch and see if he can catch them nursing. Sometimes it's hard to catch them because they just do it such short periods, little sips here and there. So, but you do want to make sure that the baby is active and alert and getting the colostrum right in the beginning.
Today has definitely been another great day, and we are so excited about our new babies, and we cannot wait to share this with you guys and to see what Fancy Girl has next. I think she's going to have multiples, so that ought to be even more interesting. But if you haven't already, please subscribe, like, and share, and we'll see you next time on Wholesome Roots.